This lecture notes is submitted from Department of Physics and Engineering Mathematics, Faculty of Engineering in Shams University. The lecture notes is on the course coded PHM 211, Numerical Methods. First, we deal with numerical solutions of nonlinear equations. We speak about roots of nonlinear equations and give some important information. Our objective is the solution of an equation of the form fx equals 0, where fx is any equation. This equation is called a polynomial equation of degree n in x, when n is a positive integer. If it has the form a naught x power n plus a1 x power n minus 1 plus up to an x power n equals 0. And this the equation fx equals 0 is called a transcendental equation if it contains one or more transcendental functions like sine x, cosine x, sine x, cosine x, ln x, e power x, and so on. We give the following definition. A number small r is called a root of the equation fx equals 0 if fr equals 0, that is the value of f when x equals r equals 0. This number r is called a 0 of f of x, or a root of the equation fx equals 0, and the difference x minus r is called a factor of f of x. For a polynomial equation of degree n, we give the following important information. The number of roots equals n, exactly n. These roots may be real, different or equal, or complex. The complex roots occur in pairs. That is, if x equals a plus ib is a root, the conjugate a minus ib is also a root. Here, I denotes the imaginary unit square root of negative 1. The polynomial equations of odd degree have at least one real root. For transcendental equations, the fact that most transcendental functions cannot be solved explicitly necessitates the use of numerical methods to find approximate roots to a desired degree or prescribed degree of accuracy. Now we will speak about numerical methods for locating and finding a root of the equation fx equals 0. The first method is called the bisection method or the method of halving. If fx is a continuous function of x and f at a times f at b is less than 0 for a less than b, then f of x equals 0 has at least one root in the interval a or b, a and b. The number of steps required to reach an approximated root is determined from n is greater than log b minus a minus log 2 epsilon divided by log 2, where epsilon is greater than 0 is the pre-specified error or prescribed error. Now we give an illustrating example. Example 1. How many steps of bisecting method are needed to determine the root of the equation fx equals 0, which lies in the interval 1.2 and 1.8, open interval, of course, with an error of at most 5 times 10 to the power minus 6 solution. Here we have a equals 1.2 and b equals 1.8 and epsilon equals 5 times 10 to the power minus 6. Substituting in the formula on slide number 6, the previous slide, we obtain the value of n must be greater than 15.872. Consequently, we can take n equals 16. Example 2. Find correct to two decimal places the smallest positive root of the equation x cubed minus x minus 1 equals 0. For the solution, first we must locate the root of this equation as follows. We have fx equals x cubed minus x minus 1. F at 0 equals minus 1. F at 1 equals minus 1. F at 2 equals 5. That is, F at 1 is negative and F at 2 is positive. In other words, if x changes sign between 1 and 2, this means that fx equals 0 has a root in the open interval 1 and 2. If we look or see the table in the next slide, we see that the value of A7 and B7 are the first two decimals. The same. The required root is therefore the value of C7, which is 1.3243. Before locating at the table of calculations, we give the following two remarks. The first, if the root is required to be correct to k decimals, round off A, B, and C to k plus 2 decimals. The second remark, it is better to arrange calculations in a tabular form. This table shows the calculations of our example. The first column gives the step number or the number of iteration, and the next columns show the value of A, C, B, if at A, if at C, if at B, respectively. As we already said, if we look at the end of this table, we notice that the value of A and the value of B coincide in two decimals, 1.3204 and 1.3282. The value of A and B have the same first two decimals, and the value of C is half their sum, which is 1.3243, and we take this value as the required root. Now we give another example, show that the equation e power negative 5x sine pi by 4 plus sine 5x minus pi by 4 equals 0 has a root in 0.6 and 0.9 open interval. Find two, three decimals this root by using the bisection method. For the solution, we have if at 0.6 equals plus 0.8 and if at 0.9 equals negative 0.5, that is if x has different signs and changes its sign between the values 0.6 and 0.8. Consequently, if x equals 0, have a root in the interval 0.6 and 0.8 as required. The calculations are given in the following table, the table on the next slide. and the required value for the root is C9. That equals 0.78839. This table shows the calculations required for the example number 3 on the previous slide. If we look at the last row, we see that the value of A is 0.788 and the value of B 0.78868. The two values have the same 3 decimals. And the value of C is half their sum, which is 0.78839. We take this value as the required root. The first, the second method is the method of iteration or the method of successive approximations or the method of fixed point. According to the method of iteration, we give the following information. Consider the equation fx equals 0, where f is continuous and differentiable. The second, let fx equals 0 has only one root in the open interval a and b. To find this root, rewrite the equation fx equals 0 in the form x equals g of x, such that or provided that the absolute value of g dash x is less than 1 on this interval a and b. The condition, the absolute value of g dash x is less than 1, is called the condition of convergence to the exact root. If 2 equals minus log 2 minus 3, which is negative. And f at 3 equals minus log 3 minus 1, which also is negative. While f at 4 equals 1 minus log 4, which is greater than 0. Therefore, the equation has a root in the interval 3 and b, open interval. Now, rewrite the equation as x equals g of x. We can write this equation as the following. X equals 7 divided 2 plus half log x. In this case, gx equals 7 divided 2 plus half log x. And the absolute value of g dash x equals the absolute value of 1 divided 2x ln 10. Now, The absolute value of g dash at 3 is or equals 0.07238, which is less than 1. And the absolute value of g dash 4 equals 0.05428681, which also is less than 1. This means that the condition g dash x in absolute value is less than 1 on the interval a over b is satisfied. Now, we choose the initial approximation of the root as follows. X naught equal half 3 plus 4, which equals 3.5. The successive approximations are obtained from xn plus 1 equals 7 divided 2 plus half log xn, and n equals 0, 1, 2, and so on. The successive approximations are x1 equals 3.77203, and x2, the second approximation, equals 3.78829. The third approximation is x3 equals 3.78922. And this is the required approximation. The next example 5, by the method of iteration, find correct two decimals the real positive root of the equation x cubed minus x minus 1 equals 0 for the solution. The value of f when x equals 1 equals negative 1, and the value of f when x equals 2 equals 5. That is, if x changes sign between 1 and 2. This means that the required root, or there exists a root in the open interval 1 and 2. Rewrite the equation as x equals x cubed minus 1. This means that gx equals x cubed minus 1. This choice is rejected because, or since, g dash x in absolute value, that is equal 3x squared minus 1 in absolute value is greater than 1. The condition of convergence is not satisfied. As another choice, we can write x equals 1 over x plus 1 over x squared equals gx. This means that gx equals 1 over x plus 1 over x squared. For the condition of convergence, we find that modulus g dash x is greater than 1 over the interval 1 and 2. This choice is also rejected because the condition of convergence is not satisfied. as a third choice we can write the equation as 4x equals cubic root of x plus 1 equals gx. This means that gx equals the cubic root of x plus 1. We accepted this choice since the absolute value of g dash x is less than 1 over the interval 1 and 2. The respective or the successive approximations are obtained from the relation xn plus 1 equals the cubic root of xn plus 1. And n takes the values 0 and 2 and so on. X naught equals half the sum of 1 and 2, which equals 1.5. Substitute in the above relation for n equals 0, we obtain x1 equals the cubic root of x0 plus 1. That equals 1.3572. And for n equals 1, the relation gives the second approximation x2 equals the cubic root of x1 plus 1, which equals 1.3309, and so on up to x4 and x3, which coincide, their values coincide in two decimals, 1.32 and 1.32, in both successive approximations. Since x3 and x4 have the same first two decimals, the required root is 1.3249, while the exact root of the equation is 1.3247179577. More methods for finding an approximate root of the equation fx equals 0. In addition to the bisection method and the successive approximation method, we have the method of secant or the method of false position and the method of Newton-Raphson. These two methods are left to be studied by the student. Now, we handle the systems of nonlinear equations. Consider the system of two nonlinear equations, small f at x and y equals 0, and small g f x and y equals 0. Suppose that the system has a single root, x equals r and y equals s. That is, the root belongs to the open interval or and is in some region omega in the xy plane. We suppose that f and g and their partial derivatives up to the second order are continuous in the same region omega. Let x0 and y0 or x0 and y0 be an approximation in omega to the exact root r and s. Successive approximations xi and yi, where I equals 1, 2, 3, and so on, that is x1, y1, and x2, and y2, and so on. The successive approximations which converge to r and s may be obtained by two major methods, the method of iteration and the method of Newton. For the method of iteration, we have to rewrite the given system in the form x equals capital F of x and y, and y equals capital G of x and y, such that the absolute value of fx plus the absolute value of fy must be less than 1, and the absolute value of gx and the absolute value of gy is less than 1 in omega. This is called the condition of convergence. In this condition, fx denotes partial f by partial x, and fy partial f by partial y, while gx equals partial g by partial x, and gy equals partial g by partial y. For the successive approximations, we can use xn plus 1 equals capital F calculated at xn and yn, while yn plus 1 equals capital G calculated at xn plus 1 just obtained and yn. And for the values n equals 0, 1, 2, and so on. As an example, find the solution correct to two decimals near 1 and 2 of the system sine x equals y minus 0.85 and the cosine y equals x minus 1.32. First, we have to rewrite the given system in the form x equals capital F and y equals capital G. So, we can write x equals 1.32 plus cosine y, while small y equals 0.85 plus sine x, which is capital G of x and y. For the condition of convergence, we have mod fx plus mod fy equals mod sine x, which is less than 1, and mod gx plus mod gy, that equals mod cosine x, is also less than 1. This condition is satisfied in some region about the point 1 and 2. We can use the iteration method, remembering that 1 radian equals 180 divided by pi in degrees. X1, the first approximation of x is x1, and use x1 to obtain y1. Then, for n equals 1, we obtain the second approximation. X2 equals 1.2551, and use this result to get y2, that equals 1.8006, while x3, the third approximation for x, is 1.0922. Use this value to obtain the third approximation of y3 equals 1.7376, and so on. While x6 equals 1.1384, and x7 equals 1.1339, and y6 1.75, and y7 equals 1.7561. The two successive approximations of x coincide or have the same first two decimals, and the corresponding two successive approximations for y have also coincide in two decimals, 1.75. Therefore, the solution correct to two decimals is x equals 1.339 and y equals 1.7561. Now, we will speak about systems of linear equations. Consider the following system of linear equations: E times the vector x equals the vector b. In this form, capital A denotes the matrix of coefficients, while the vector x is the vector of unknowns, x1, x2, x3, and so on. And b denotes the vector of free terms. We shall consider the case when this system has only one solution. As you are as you know, the system AX equals B maybe have a unique solution, has only one solution, or has an infinite number of solutions, or has no solution at all. Here we use the case when this system has only one solution. Example, find the solution of the system consisting of the three equations x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 equals 11 and 3x1 minus x2 plus 2x3 equals 12 and 2x1 minus 2x2 minus x3 equals 2. Here the matrix A is the first column represents the coefficients of x1 in the given equations, which are 1, 3, 2 respectively, while the second column represents the coefficients of x2, which are 2, minus 1, minus 2 respectively. The third column represents the coefficients of x3, which are 3, 2, minus 1 respectively. The vector x is the vector of unknowns, includes 3 unknowns, x1, x2, x3. The free terms are 11, 12, 2 respectively. This system can be solved using different methods. The first, by using determinants or by using Cramer's rule. The solution is the value of xi equals delta sub I divided by delta, where I equals 1, 2, 3, while delta I is obtained from delta by replacing the coefficients of xi by the three free terms. The second method is by using the inverse matrix of A. The solution in this case is the vector x equals the inverse matrix of A multiplied by the vector B, provided A inverse exists. Third method, Gauss elimination method. This can be done by transforming the matrix AB, the augmented matrix A line B, to the following upper triangular form. AB is the form given 100, the second column 0.68 and negative 1.72 and 0. The third column negative 0.24, 1.96, negative 12.5, and the free terms are respectively 1.05, negative 1, 2.7, 6.18 respectively. We notice that the matrix A is an upper triangular matrix as stated above. The solution is obtained by back substitution as follows. We start from the last row, the third row, to get x3. Then substitute this value of x3 in the previous row to get the value of x2. Then substitute the values of x2 and x3 into the first equation to get the value of x1. The solution as seen is x1 equals 0.245 and x2 equals 1.01 and x3 equals negative 0.494. The next method is called Gauss-Jordan elimination method. Using simple row operations, we can transform the equation Ax equals b into an equivalent equation I C. A, the augmented matrix of A over B, is equivalent to the augmented matrix of I and C. I is the unit matrix of the same order as A. The solution will be x equals c. The next method is called Jacobi method. Jacobi method to solve the system xi equals small fi of x1, x2, xn, and I equals 1, 2, 3, n. That is, x1 equals small f1 of x1, x2, xn, small x2 equals small f2 of x1, x2, xn, and so on, up to xn equals small f sub n of x1, x2, xn. To solve this system, rewrite the given system in the form xi, x of I equals capital F of x1, x2, xn, and I equals 1, 2, 3, up to n, provided that the absolute value of partial f I by partial x1 plus the absolute value of partial f I by partial x2 plus the absolute value of partial f I by partial x2 is less than 1. And this is true for I equals 1 to n. That is, 1 divided the absolute value of a n times sum over j from 1 to n the absolute value of Aij is less than 1, where g doesn't equal to I. This implies that the absolute value of Aii is greater than some. The absolute value of Aij for g equals 1 to n. G doesn't equal to I, and I runs from 1 to n. As an example, we introduce the following example. Use Jacobi method to find correct two decimals the solution of these three equations. We have a system of three linear equations. The first equation is 2x1 plus 5x2 minus x3 equals 2. Second equation is 4x1 minus x2 plus x3 equals 3. And the third equation, x1 plus 2x2 plus 6x3 equals 5. We can take the initial approximation for the values of x1, x2, x3 as x0 denoted by x0 equals the transpose of the vector 0, 0, 0. For the condition of convergence to be satisfied, from the second equation we choose x1, since coefficient of x1 is in absolute value is greater than the absolute value of the coefficient of x2 plus the absolute value of the coefficient of x3 from the first equation. We choose x2 since the coefficient of x2 in absolute value is greater than the sum of the absolute values of the coefficient of x1 and the coefficient of x3. From the third equation, we choose x3, since the coefficient of x3 in absolute value is greater than the sum of absolute values of the coefficient of x1 and the coefficient of x2. Rewrite the equations as: from the first equation, we, as stated above, we choose x1, and we can write x1 n plus 1, that is the approximation number n plus 1 of the unknown x1 equals 0.75 plus 0.25 times x2n minus 0.25 times x3n. The second equation is x2 n plus 1, the n plus first approximation of x of the unknown x2 equals 0.40 minus 0.40 times x1n plus 0.20 times x3n. And at last, x3n plus 1 equals 0.8333 minus 1 minus 0.1667 times xn times x1n minus 0.3333 times x2n, and n takes the values 0, 1, 2, and so on. For the first approximation, we obtain x11 equals 0.75 and x21 equals 0.4, x31 equals 0.8333. Second approximation is x12 equals 0.6417 and x22 equals 0.2667, x32 equals 0.5750. We must continue this process until the values of all the unknowns are the same, correct to 2 decimals. The solution is x1 equals 0.66 and x2 equals 0.26 and x3 equals 0.64. This is the solution obtained when we rounded the approximations to 2 decimals. But without rounding the successive approximations, the solution will be x1 equals 0.6575, x2 equals 0.2653, x3 equals 0.6359. The next method is Gauss-Seidel method. Gauss-Seidel iteration method. A modification to Jacobi method is done by using the obtained approximations directly in the next equations. Example, solve the example in Jacobi method by Gauss-Seidel method with x0, the initial approximation, equals the transpose of the vector 0, 0, 0 solution. As in the example in Jacobi method, we can write the following formulas: x1 n plus 1 equals 0.75 plus 0.25 x2n minus 0.5x3n, ou x2n plus 1, equals 0.4 minus 0.4 times x1 n plus 1, just obtained, plus 0.2x3n. The next is x3 n plus 1 equals 0.8333 minus 0.1667 times the obtained x1 n plus 1 minus 0.3333 times x2 n plus 1 just obtained. For n equals 0, if we substitute the value of n by 0, we find that, and using these relations, we find that x1 1 equals 0.75 and x2 1 equals 0.1, while x3 1 equals 0.6749. For n equals 1, x1 2, the second approximation of x1 is 0.6063, and x2 2 equals 0.2925, x3n equals 0.6347. For n equals 2, the approximations as written: x13 equals 0.6645, x23 equals 0.2611, and x33 equals 0.6355. For n equals 3, we find that x14 equals 0.6564, x24 0.2645, and x34 equals 0.6357. The solution rounded to decimals is x1 equals 0.66 and x2 0.26 and x3 equals 0.64. This completes the lecture notes. See you again in another lecture notes. Thank you very much.